When you're blessed with a little girl, you immediately start dreaming about her future. For most parents, saving for their child's future is a major financial goal. And the government gives a helping hand to parents saving for their daughter's future through the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana. You're watching Why Not Mint Money, and I'm Nilanjana from Mint's personal finance team. We're talking about the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, which is one of the most lucrative small savings schemes at present. Since October 2018, the rate of interest for the SSY has been 8.5%, compounded yearly. Only the senior citizen savings scheme offers a higher interest rate at present, which is at 8.6%. Launched in January 2015, the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana is part of the government's larger Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao campaign. It is aimed at encouraging and incentivizing Indian parents to educate and nurture their daughters. Under the scheme, the parent or guardian of the girl child between the ages of 0 and 10 can open an account in the child's name. Deposits can be made on a monthly or yearly basis for the next 15 years from the date of opening of the account. Investments can't be made, however, after the 15-year period. But the account keeps gaining interest for the next 7 years and matures after 21 years. But you can only withdraw the full corpus after the child turns 18, subject to certain conditions. Through an amendment made to the Sukanya Samriddhi account rules in 2018, the minimum amount needed to open the account was lowered to 250 rupees from 1000 rupees. The maximum you can invest in a year is rupees 1.5 lakh. The returns from the scheme are declared every quarter and they're guaranteed. So it works out well for parents who want to ensure that the money they put away for their child is safeguarded from any market volatility. As with other government saving schemes, the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana offers great tax benefits. Deposits made under the scheme qualify for tax deduction of up to 1.5 lakh under Section 80C of the Income Tax Act. The amount of interest earned through the account as well as the maturity amount is also tax-free. To open a Sukanya Samriddhi account, you can approach a post office or an authorized bank branch. You will need an account opening form which the bank or post office will provide. You will also need to carry the beneficiary's birth certificate and identity proof as well as address proof of the guardian or parents of the beneficiary. The Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana is ideal for parents saving for their daughter's education since the investment horizon aligns with the child graduating and pursuing higher education. But it works best if you open the account when your daughter is very young. If you start investing in it when your daughter is more than say 4 or 5 years old, the account will only mature when your daughter is in her mid-20s, by which time the need to fund her higher education may have passed. In such cases, the maturity amount can be used for other financial goals, like her wedding or buying property in her name or even funding an entrepreneurial venture. Keep in mind that the lock-in period is not till your daughter turns 21 but 21 years after the account is open. This means that if you open an account when your daughter is say 10, you can only fully withdraw the total amount after she is 30. This would mean that the money will likely not be available to fund major milestones and needs like her higher education, wedding, etc. The scheme allows partial withdrawal for marriage and higher education purposes once the child turns 18, but the withdrawal is limited to only 50% of the amount in the account at the end of the preceding financial year. The key to making the most of the Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana is to plan carefully and invest early so that the corpus can come in handy when your daughter sets off to achieve her ambitions. That's all for now from us at Why Not Mint Money. Do keep watching for more.